Good day to you and welcome back. In the previous lecture, we looked at the rudder lift and what are the resistance acting on the rudder, frictional drag and the foam drag. And we saw that how the rudder lift is getting created, and this is the formula. In this formula, you already saw that what is the acceleration turn, how the accelerator turn is occurring and what is the reason for that one. And we talk about the lift coefficient of lift, and this is a formula in order to find out the actual rudder lift. Okay, now let's look at, like, if I ask a question, why the maximum rudder angle in most of the merchant ships, max for this shape, right, maximum rudder angle is around 35 degrees, right? The maximum rudder angle is about 35 degrees. Why is that? Why it is not 45, 60, all are small angles, less than 90 degrees. For example, if I write 15 degrees also, 25 degrees, 60 degrees, 75 degrees, all these are less than 90 degrees. All these are less than 90 degrees. But why this significant value? Why it is 35 degrees? Okay, we'll look at that one. What is the reason? Right now, if we put the rudder back again, right to starboard, this is the ship's head, right? The ship said this is starboard rudder. Now, if you can remember, in the previous lectures we already saw that if there are two types of flows occurring in the sides, but if you increase the angle furthermore, right, after a certain angle, you can see that this water molecule is having trouble to come over here, right? It has some trouble. It is experiencing trouble because the separation is so much wider. Because when the rudder angle is higher, right, this is the rudder angle, and when the rudder angle is higher, you can see that this water molecule is having a difficulty to come over to this place. Instead, it will end up somewhere here, for example, and there will be a void created inside in between this water molecule and this water molecule, right? Maybe it will end up somewhere here because the angle is so high, and when this one supposed to follow the shape of the rudder itself, but it cannot follow because the angle is so high, there is a momentum that this water molecule is having, so it will be end up somewhere here. When it ends up somewhere here and the other water molecule is somewhere here, there will be a separation, a wider separation, and other water molecules will come and fill the area with turbulence. So there will be huge amount of turbulence creating here, right, which will not create a lift force. There won't be any lift force getting created. Instead, a huge drag force is getting created, right? So you can see this is rudder angle, and this is coefficient of lift. If we draw the coefficient lift, it will increase with the rudder angle, but at a certain point, it will come to a maximum. After that, it will come down, right? There won't be any lift force getting created after a certain point. So for this shape, you can see there is a maximum rudder angle, right? There is a maximum rudder angle, right? This is the maximum where the maximum lift is getting created. So this lift would be maximum at this angle only. After that, if you furthermore give higher rudder angles, instead the drag will be increasing. There won't be any lift. So this is occurring somewhere around 35 degrees for this shape. for this shape, this is occurring somewhere around 35. So that is why most of the ships are having, right, a maximum rudder angle of 35. This is the reason. So this is called the stall angle. So this is called the stall angle, right? So the maximum rudder angle stall, this is because the reason is this is where it is going to stall, right? The lift is going to stall here, so this is the maximum rudder lift, right? And normally in merchant ships this is happening around 35 degrees. Right, now what if we give a stern kick? When we give a stern kick, let's say the vessel is moving towards stern and we give a rudder angle. So what will happen to the lift and drag in this case? It has been shown by the research that for this shape, the rudder lift for a stern movement, the rudder lift is going to reduce up to 45 to 75%. The rudder lift is basically going to reduce, right, when we give a stern motion. So if you are going to use the rudder in a stern motion to get some turn, it will be not that much effective compared to the head motion. So in a stern motion, a rudder movement is not going to be much effective compared to the head motion. So this is proved, this has been proved by research. Plus, if you look at the stall angle, that means the maximum rudder angle, right, or the maximum lift will be occurring. In the head motion, it is around 35 degrees, but in stern motion, the maximum lift is going to occur 5 to 10 degrees less than 35. So there is a reduction of 5 to 10 degrees in the stall angle. There is a reduction, right? So this is this by the research, it has been proved that why this is happening. Right. So these are basically the forces acting. There may be other forces, but for us, when it comes to ship dynamics, these two are the major forces. Right now, in the next lectures, we will look at how the ship is going to turn, what is the overshooting of the ship, and the pivot point, and the turning circle. Everything we will be looking at when it comes to the next lectures. Thank you very much.